Have you ever wished to control your dreams? This is the Halo, a device that might make this into a reality. The Halo is engineered to enable lucid dreaming, a sleep state where you're fully aware and in control of your dreams, remembering them as if they were real experiences. It's not just any device. This is a visionary collaboration involving the startup company Prophetic, together with some of the brightest minds in technology. Afshin Mehin, acclaimed for designing Elon Musk's Neuralink, and his team are at the forefront of the creative design of the Halo. Additionally, Sterling Crispin from Apple's Vision Pro team is also involved as a senior advisor. The Halo works its magic while you sleep. Worn like a headband, it uses targeted ultrasound signals to induce lucid dreaming, providing a non-invasive method to stimulate your brain. With the Halo, users can do a variety of activities in their sleep, like practice the violin, travel to different locations, or even create poetry. Lucid dreamers can reshape their dream's story, characters, and setting at will. Its founder, Eric Wolberg, has already raised more than $1 million in funding, and the device is expected to launch in 2025. While the Halo represents a leap in technology, dreaming itself has long been a subject of fascination in our collective history. While billionaires are jetting off into space and quantum computing is becoming a reality, the truth is, we still know very little about why or how we dream. It is one aspect of human nature that continues to remain elusive. But first, what is a dream? Dreams are commonly perceived as a series of thoughts, images, and sensations that occur in a person's mind during sleep. Within this unconscious realm, our deepest feelings, fears, and desires manifest and play out. So, is it really possible to control your dreams? This is Dave Green, an extraordinary artist who has honed the ability to control his mind during sleep, a master and architect of his dream world. Dave has taught himself how to enter a lucid dream state, a skill he perfected over years of training. As he drifts off to sleep and transitions into dreamland, he begins to draw a simple circle, a symbol he uses as a portal into his dream-induced artistic journeys. In these dreams, Dave experiences a world without physical limitations or conventional rules, where his thoughts and subconscious create abstract landscapes and forms. Dave experiments with new techniques, impossible geometries, and explores themes far beyond the scope of his consciousness. Upon waking, his first task is to transfer these visions onto paper. This process is a delicate balance of memory and skill, capturing the scenes from his subconscious. Each piece you see here is more than art. It's a snapshot of the dream, a visual diary of his nocturnal adventures. Dave's ability to bring his imagination to life is a testament to the power of lucid dreaming. Just as he channels his dreams into art, this power opens up a realm of endless possibilities. With practice, anyone can learn to navigate their dream world, accomplishing extraordinary things like mastering a talent or reconnecting with a lost loved one. Lucid dreaming isn't just a modern idea, though. It's been a part of Buddhism for thousands of years. In Tibet, monks practice something called dream yoga during their sleep. It's a form of meditation they use to reach a deeper spiritual understanding of themselves. But what if we could communicate with someone while they're dreaming? This idea, once thought to only exist in the science fiction world, became a reality in 2021, thanks to Dr. Ken Paller and Karen Kunkali of Northwestern University, who developed a new approach to communicate with people during their sleep. The duo and their team trained individuals to recognize when they were in a lucid dream and to signal their awareness through predetermined eye movements or facial expressions. They interacted with the dreamers by asking questions or giving instructions, to which the dreamers responded using the predetermined signals. After waking up, the participants could recall these interactions, confirming their conscious awareness during their sleep. This discovery provides a glimpse into the future potential that two-way communication in dream states can offer. Imagine a world where therapists could guide patients through sessions in their dreams, directly addressing subconscious issues or traumas. Or, teachers could provide immersive language learning experiences, engaging students in conversations in foreign languages while they dream. I know, crazy stuff. However, lucid dreaming isn't always a result of deliberate effort. Sometimes, it happens spontaneously. Every day, there are countless stories shared online about people who unexpectedly become aware they're dreaming, describing the experience as profound and impactful. But just how common is this phenomenon? It's believed that around 50% of people will experience lucid dreaming at a basic level at least once. About 20% may encounter such dreams monthly, and less than 1% experience them several times a week. Lucid dreams typically happen during the REM phase, a stage of sleep that begins around 90 minutes after you go to bed. During REM, there's an increase in brain activity, breathing, heart rate, and blood pressure. Have you ever experienced lucid dreaming? Aristotle, the ancient Greek philosopher, was one of the first to describe this idea of a conscious dream state. He believed that dreams could stem from real-life experiences, and that, during sleep, the senses could still perceive external stimuli, which might be integrated into dreams, leading to a state of lucid dreaming. Today, we ask, how does lucid dreaming open up new possibilities for understanding the human brain? One area is its therapeutic applications. Lucid dreaming can be a powerful tool in managing and overcoming trauma, particularly in treating conditions like PTSD. While the idea of controlling our dreams is intriguing, disturbing our natural sleep patterns might also lead to sleep issues or affect sleep's restorative qualities. Dreams reflect our subconscious, and frequently altering this space could cause issues like reliance on technology or even difficulty distinguishing between reality and dreams. While advancement in our scientific research is exciting, they also bring us to an important discussion of ethics and freedom. Could our dreams become a new playground for advertisers? Imagine if a device like the Halo, initially created to induce lucid dreaming, could also be programmed to implement ads directly into our sleep. These major tech companies could tailor ads to our personal tastes within our unconscious world. While the technology holds promise, the venture into commercial dream-based activity requires a necessary balance between technological advancement and the sanctity of our personal mental space. But whether we like it or not, we are entering a world where our dreams will not just be a passive experience, but a productive extension of our waking life. Throughout human history, dreams are considered more than just nighttime narratives. They're gateways to creativity, healing, and self-discovery. As we continue to push the boundaries of what's possible, let's cherish this extraordinary adventure. Keep dreaming, keep exploring, and let's see where our dreams take us next. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more fascinating topics like this. Thanks for watching.